So smartphone manufacturers are going crazy over cameras. We can see multiple camera sensors on a single smartphone. And now we've reached a point where a smartphone has a 50 times zoom sensor on it. Well, it's none other than the Huawei P30 Pro. It has a 40 megapixel main sensor, a 20 megapixel ultra-wide sensor, a periscope zoom lens, and a time-of-flight sensor for depth mapping as well. So in this video, we'll discover all of the cameras on the Huawei P30 Pro and find out its true potential. Alright, let's start with something that P30 Pro is really good at, the periscope zoom lens. So the periscope zoom lens offers you 5 times optical zoom, 10 times hybrid zoom and 50 times digital zoom as well. So at first, I was really skeptic about using the zoom level beyond 10 times. However, after using the P30 Pro for a while, I did start to get more creative. For an instance, I went to Patan for our little shootout with the P30 Pro and it was a very good place to try out the prowess of the periscope zoom lens. Now take a look at this first picture. This is right opposite of the Patan Museum, near the Krishna temple. I guess it's called Garudh or something like that. And this first picture is a normal one. Now we go a little closer with the 5x zoom and I absolutely love this picture. It was a overcast day and that's why it has that darker profile to it. There's good amount of contrast and I like how I was able to isolate the subject without losing details. Then I went even closer with the 10x zoom and yeah, you can see that we're able to get a very nice shot without distracting the pigeons. I think this is the real usefulness of the P30 Pro zoom lens. You can get really close to the subject, just isolate it and get a different perspective rather than just a normal wide shot. Now moving on to this picture, this is shot with the default lens and it came out pretty nice. Now we move on a little closer with 5x optical zoom and then we move on to 10x hybrid zoom. So this gives us more isolated look at the temple and I really like this one. Without the buildings, the temple alone looks really good. And these are the real world uses of the zoom lens. It's useful when you want to take isolated picture of a subject and we can get even closer with the 10x hybrid zoom and the picture still looks good with crisp details in the temple and those bricks seem to have really nice lines. Now I'm using the 32x zoom and this one is yet. It's a little gimmicky at this moment, however the zoom lens of the P30 Pro is definitely very impressive. Now moving on to the night shots, I've used the P20 Pro, the Mate 20 Pro and those phones were good at night shots as well. But the P30 Pro does it exceptionally well. So to put the P30 Pro's night mode up to the test, I decided to capture some pictures around Basantapur at night time. So I arrived here at around 6:45 and this is the first picture of the Tholezu temple and it was clicked right at 6:52 PM. At first, I was not using the night mode. This is just the normal photo mode and it looks good even without the night mode. This picture has ISO of 2000 and the overall picture without the night mode looks pretty detailed. However, you can see slight noise around the sky. Now this image is of the same temple but we are using the night mode in this one and you can clearly notice the improvement. The noise has been reduced by a lot, the exposure is balanced and this one has more details as well. So the picture already looked good with the auto mode but now it looks even better. Now onto the second nighttime image, this place is further ahead as we head down the road. As you can see, this picture has been shot without the night mode and the image still looks decent. However, the picture looks blurry at edges, the tree right ahead is a little dark and does not have details. Now if we take a look at the one with the night mode, look at that, instant upgrade. First thing, the tree now has much more detail and I really like how you can even see the details on the leaves and the colors. And the building right in front of us also has more detail now, the exposure has been lifted heavily and the overall result is a great night shot of the Kagyur temple. Likewise, this shot of Darbar Square is shot without night mode exactly at 7:04 PM and as you can see, it was quite dark and there are no heavy light source near this side of Darbar Square. So now, as you switch to the night mode, the 7-second exposure gives you a far better picture. You can even see details underneath the ceiling right at this part of the building. You can see there and at the windows as well. So the night mode gives you instant upgrade over the normal mode, but the normal mode is also quite good. Now this last one, it was really pitch dark as you can see in the image, which was shot without the night mode. Even my naked eye could not really make up the details on those buildings. Now with the night mode, look at that. The 6-second exposure is working really nice. We're getting those good details of the buildings on the right and the main white building as well. It looks really good. Now that we have talked about the periscope zoom lens and night mode, it's time we look at the wide angle lens. So the wide angle lens gives you this completely new perspective of anything you shoot and I love clicking buildings with this wide lens. The images appear really nice, the pictures do lose slight details with the wide angle lens and the autofocus with the wide lens is also not as good as the main lens. However, I was very impressed with the balanced dynamic range, the colors and the exposure with the wide angle lens. Now using the wide angle lens in the night is kind of tricky though. You can use the night mode with the wide angle lens as well. However, results will not be as good as what you get with the main sensor. However, one thing you can do with the wide angle sensor is capture some beautiful macro shots. The 16mm focal length lets you get really close to the subject and still have the object on focus. The macro shots turn out really nice. You can get creative with these macro shots, and I loved taking macro shots with this wide angle lens, especially the picture of flowers as you can see here. Well, that's that. Now let's take a look at some portrait photos as well. I do not click much portrait pictures, however I do have some couple of samples to show here. For this first picture here, the edge detection is good. The background blur is also nice and the overall picture looks good. It's decent. Now on to the next one. This was shot on an overcast day. The background blur is gradual, which you can realize with the way the pavement hasn't blurred out. The edge detection is also good. However, the person has turned out a bit darker and you'll see it better when we compare the normal photo and the portrait photo. So the portrait photos turn out really nice. I think that time of flight sensor definitely helps in getting more natural kind of blur, and I think it's good. Now as we move on to the front camera, the selfies come out really clean. There are lots of details and the selfies look very sharp. The colors also look neutral. There are no extra color boosts, and I really like how the selfies turn out. However, I did turn off all the beauty modes, and the AI HDR also helps to achieve good selfies when the background have bright sunlight. Now something extra that I would like to talk about is the monochrome feature. I was just experimenting with it and I was not really interested in those pictures, but after exporting the pictures onto my PC, I stumbled upon these monochrome pictures and they looked absolutely beautiful. I really love these pictures. You should definitely try out the monochrome on the P30 Pro if you own it. So well, let's move on to the videos now. So in video mode, the P30 Pro shoots in 1080p Full HD by default, but you can go up to 4K UHD with a maximum recording time of 10 minutes per clip. So the OIS and AIS work really well together to make your handheld shots very smooth, and the videos are better than the Mate 20 Pro, and you can even use the 5x optical zoom and the 10x hybrid zoom while recording video. In addition, you can also shoot with the wide angle lens as well. So to conclude, the Huawei P30 Pro is definitely one of the best camera smartphones available right now. The night mode works excellent, and the thing is, you don't even need to use a night mode. The normal auto mode does quite a brilliant job. And now talking about the 5x optical zoom and the 10x hybrid zoom, they work really well. And not to forget, you can take some beautiful wide angle shots and some beautiful macro shots as well. So Huawei P30 Pro is definitely one of the most versatile camera smartphone, and it's superb. So that's it for this video. Hope you guys liked it, and as always, like if you liked it, subscribe to the channel for further contents like this, and also hit that bell icon to get notifications. Until next time, namaste.